There was no bigger television show than Dallas, and there was no better leading lady than Linda Gray, who betrayed the Sue Ellen, the scheming, vodka-swilling wife of J.R. Ewing. Now, for Throwback Thursday, she's taking and talking to Craig Bennett and all of us about the heyday of the Southfork Ranch.
You look absolutely fabulous.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right now, people in Australia are saying, how does she do it? Exercise?
All those things. All
fasting.
Those things. Fasting.
Mm-hmm. I knew I'd hit the secret.
How did you know this?
Because I'm psychic.
Oh, no, it's going to be one of those interviews.
It's hard to believe that as a kid you had polio and feared you may never walk.
Yes, but it didn't bother me at all. When I look back at my life, I think that's when I decided that nothing was going to bother me.
Is it true you began your life as a model, your working showbiz life?
I did, but I didn't consider it showbiz life at all. It was working. I loved to work.
And you really became the queen of TV commercials here in America, didn't you, for quite a while?
I did.
Mommy, the elephant has wrinkly pantyhose just like yours.
It was terribly embarrassing.
I had that all-American face, I suppose. That's what they told me.
1967, your leg becomes world famous. The poster for The Graduate, but nobody knew that that was your leg.
Nobody knew.
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me.
I got $12.50 per leg.
Did you?
$25 American, yeah.
Is that it?
Yep.
You didn't spend it all at once, I hope, did you?
I might have. And here's to you,
Mrs. Robinson. Elizabeth Taylor was very jealous of your leg.
Well, but she was lovely. I really liked her. And her quote to me was, oh, that's the bitch with the long legs. That's what she called me. And I thought, oh, well, that's an interesting quote. But we laughed and we giggled and, you know, I think I turned around and said, yeah, you're the one with the short legs. And we got along great. We really, really did. In restless dreams
I walked alone. You did The Graduate, both on the West End stage and on the Broadway stage as well.
I did.
As Mrs. Robinson.
Yes.
That's kind of serendipitous, don't you think?
It was. And, you know, it brought a smile to everybody's face. It was because who knew in 1967 that it would kind of go full circle?
1978, a role comes bouncing into your life, but I guess we'll kind of shake things up. She loved a drink. She was the wife of the dastardly J.R. Ewing, and we're talking, of course, the deliciously boozy Sue Ellen. I mean, was she just magic to play?
Oh, beyond. And she just kept evolving, and I loved her.
Why are you so interested in what I do with my spare time?
Because you're my wife.
When I started working with Larry, it was obvious there was trouble ahead.
It's happening all over again, isn't it? The sneaking around, the cheating.
I'm not cheating on you.
Shut up!
Larry and I had this charisma and the chemistry that very few couples have on film.
Well, if it isn't my one and only.
Your Sue Ellen turned drinking, hangovers, and having affairs into an absolute art form, didn't she? She was fabulous. Who didn't love Sue Ellen?
I know. I just loved her. It was like every time I'd sit and read the next week's script, I'd go, oh, my God, we're going to go here. Here's where we're going this week.
You mentioned the great charisma that you had with Larry Hagman. You, of course, became very close friends off camera, didn't you?
Yes.
What was the Larry like that you knew?
Incredible. He was my best friend. He was put on the planet, I think, to play that character.
Maybe we ought to go back upstairs.
Oh. He said, I've had so many drugs, I'm not scared of death. I'm just here to have a wonderful time. And a wonderful time he did. And he dragged literally everybody with him.
I just met your child bride. What junior high school were you cruising this time?
Well, that's real funny.
I've heard about the parties and the spas. Donna Mills was telling me the other day about the endeavours to get her into a spa.
Oh, yes.
And she said, no, I don't do that, I'm a lady.
Well, ladies got into the spa. I did.
Why did it end when it did? It could have gone on forever almost.
Shows have a time period. There's a natural progression and there's a natural ending. And I think that's what happened.
Decades after, of course, the original Dallas finished, you and Larry were reunited in the reboot, which must have felt really special.
Oh, talk about special. It really was.
What the hell is the matter with you, JR?
I'm sure you'll fill me in.
We got to play together and work together again.
In the reboot, of course, it then became known that Larry was struggling with his health. I mean, that was just extraordinary. And how brave was he to continue on playing J.R. Ewing, knowing that he might not have had much longer to go?
He loved what he was doing. He loved J.R. Ewing. He loved working with his old friends, Patrick and I. And he wanted to do it as long as he could, and he did.
You still don't know who you're dealing with, do you, son? I can hardly blame you for that. But I forgive you.
I read somewhere that you were with him not long before he passed away. Mm-hmm. Was he somebody that was terrified of death, or did he just embrace everything that came his way?
Patrick and I saw him 2 days before he died, and we were sitting with him 2 hours talking about old times. He was not terrified, not at all.
In the 90s, you sizzled up the screen as Heather Locklear's mum, didn't you?
Amanda.
Hello.
Mother.
Melrose Place. With our own Cameron Daddo, too, for Models, Inc. Because you kind of crossed over.
We
a bit,
crossed
didn't
over.
You?
I know. We crossed over. Great fun. In fact, my daughter said to me, Mom, you have finally arrived. And I said, What do you mean, sweetheart? She said, you're playing Heather Locklear's mother. I was like, yeah.
Once I tell Ben about how quickly you try to sell him out, I'm sure he'll do the same.
You played such a wonderful role in Models, Inc. Again, such a delicious character. You've been very lucky, haven't you?
I have, because I love playing, obviously, these dysfunctional women.
We love you in Australia, Linda Gray.
Love
when are you,
you
going
right
to come back,
back
and visit us?
Waiting for the invitation.
You really know how to wring all that juicy stuff out of the stars. Great interview. Linda so loved her years on the Dallas show that she's now a goodwill ambassador for Dallas, promoting tourism.
Oh.
And you can relive those fabulous glory days in the memoir that she's just penned to celebrate her 75th
wow.
birthday.
She looks great.
Look
wow.
at it, the road. There's that. What did she say Liz Taylor said? There's that bee with the long legs. the road to happiness is always under construction. The road to happiness is always under construction. I love that.